to right field, deep at the wall, and getting out. Preston Tucker snaps the shutout. It's now 3-1 in all four runs of the game, coming on solo dingers. Preston Tucker now with 13 home runs.
Oh, smash. Some late life coming out of these Houston Astros, hopefully. The beauty of that, it's a great thing that Preston Tucker did hit that home run. So he'd get on top of his heater. Wanted to go down and in, but up and in it. Tomahawk job from Preston Tucker puts the Astros on the board. But the good thing about that, turn that lineup over.
Now back to the top now, George Springer has that same assignment. He needs to get on base. Now Tuve's the guy that would represent the tying run if he should come to the plate. Big swing by George. Count runs to 0-2. And again, down to a strike for Houston.
He made a mistake with two strikes on Tucker. Maybe he'll make one right here for George Springer. Just find a way to extend this game.
Just getting a piece of staying alive is Springer.
He's a healthy two-strike hat.
One ball and two strikes. Rangers lead the A's 9-4 late. Yeah, that's the only game that really means anything to the Astros right now. In the inner right center field. Diving, can't get there, is Calhoun. Extra bases for Springer. He'll dig for third. And he's in with a three-bagger. So with two outs and two strikes, the Astros get the home run from Preston Tucker. And now the triple from Springer. And Altuve comes to the plate representing the tying run.
Keep pushing, boys. Springer cut down that swing a little bit. All he has to do is go out and get it. We know he's strong enough to drive the ball out of any part of this ballpark. But a good thing about being strong, too, is you don't have to swing very hard to get it past an outfielder. Found that gap. And with Cole Calhoun going down with the dive, he's able to get all the way into third base. Now a wild pitch, pass ball, gets him home. Altuve just focusing on getting on base somehow. Bring Carlos Correa to the plate.
Getting to left center field, dropping for a hit. That'll score Springer. It's now a one-run game and that familiar score here in the series. 3-2 Angels. Can Carlos Correa be the difference maker?
He's going to do it in the pass. Right man, right spot. And how big is that home run by Preston Tucker? Able to turn this lineup over and get some of these guys at the top of the Astros order that they lean on so consistently throughout the course of the season. Springer steps up with that triple. Altuve backs him up with that base hit. Now you got a meeting on the mound on how to approach Carlos Correa. Ball's not killed. Probably not the best pitch to go after, but the aggressiveness of Altuve, able to get that base hit and keep this thing going.
By the way, not bad news for the Astros. Three hits for Springer today, two for Altuve, and now Carlos Correa looking for his first of the afternoon. That's 11 Houston hits. Good swing by Carlos. A heck of a catch down the right field side in the upper tank. waiting on deck. Hot shot, diving stop, Featherston.
Take it over.
No play.
Oh,
ball gets stuck in the webbing of the glove. And it's an infield single. Stopping at second, Altuve. And that'll bring up Jed Lowry as a pinch hitter for Evan Gattis. Four consecutive two-out hits here in the ninth.
I don't think I've ever seen an infielder have that happen to him. Usually it's a smash back to the pitchers. Maybe a first baseman playing in every now and then, but that is unbelievable. He had a chance to end this game with an unbelievable play laying out to his right. But the ball hit so hard that it sticks in the webbing. What are the chances? Could this be the break that the Astros have been waiting for in September?
And now it's in the hands of a guy who didn't start the day. Jed Lowry comes on as a pinch hitter. They appeal to third, do not get the swing. Wow.
Yeah.
Two outs, and remember, there were two strikes on Preston Tucker when he launched one.
That's all right, you lose now, Jed.
Ball and a strike on Lowry.
Good pitch to hit. The only benefit I felt when I came off the bench and pinch hit. Sometimes that swing and miss kind of loosened everything up a little bit. Got your wits about you, but if he makes that pitch again, I expect Jed Lowry to get on top of it and hit it.
Ooh, just missing. It's 2-1.
That didn't look like a bad pitch from Houston Street. Got the bottom edge.
Hit high down the right field side. Deep at the foul pole. Right at the pole. And it gets out of here. Jed Lowry has hit a pinch hit 3-run home run. And the Astros lead it 5-3 in this unbelievable ninth inning.
What a game. Again, the cardiac kids, they found a way to do it at home in those late innings with their last at-bat. What possibly could be their last at-bat, they found a way on the road. A potential out caught in the web of Featherston leads to Jed Lowry getting an opportunity in the top of the ninth inning. I can't wait to see the replays because he did hit it well enough, obviously, to get it out of the ballpark. My question is, how did Cole Calhoun not catch that ball?
I thought he had the ball.
He was camped.
Yeah. That's it for Houston Street. He heads to the third base dugout as the Angels are going to go to the bullpen. But I'm with you. I was waiting to say Cole Calhoun makes the play, and it's all over.
The ball was launched, and it was high enough. It had the trajectory, but the ball was in the air so long. But Cole Calhoun had an opportunity in his home ballpark to get back to the wall. There you see him feeling for it with that left hand. Just mistimes that jump. You can see he kind of grazed himself on the wall, and that ball gets out of here. To quote Jack Buck from a long time ago in the 88 World Series, I know this is still a regular season game, but I don't believe what my eyes just saw.
Unbelievable.
He was in position to catch that ball.
Looked like he almost got stuck on the wall.
Maybe
his hip up into that padding and couldn't get up off the ground. He had the left hand perched on the top of the wall as if to help him jump. And then just never got it done.
That is incredible.
With two outs and two strikes, Preston Tucker hits a home run.
kind of a feel-good moment for Preston Tucker. That was about it.
Well, it's a feel-good moment for the team. They're like, that's sweet. We didn't get shut out again.
Maybe. George Springer gets a couple of strikes on him and then triples to right center on a ball that just eluded the glove of Calhoun. Altuve and Correa come up with hits, and then Jed Lowrie does this.
Maybe change it. But I love it. You gotta love it. It takes all 25 guys. They've been sitting back waiting for that three-run blast all road trip, it feels like. And here, no bigger moment than they need. Unbelievable.
So if you don't believe in fairy tales, I want to rethink that one.
Just change the noise level on that flight we were talking about.
Yeah, that changes things around a little bit right now. 5-3 Houston.